do you want to help people for this coronavirus? And I said, definitely, what can I do?
People want to contribute and help, and it brings out a lot of beautiful behavior in folks that everybody's willing to jump in.
As part of the role that we have in serving a broad spectrum of national security missions for the country, we have, over the years, developed a strong multidisciplinary set of capabilities here at the lab.
I currently am the operations manager for the Advanced Manufacturing Lab.
Mechanical technician here at Livermore Lab.
My background is in microbiology and immunology.
I'm a staff engineer, and my background is in biomedical engineering.
Diagnostics on pulse power projects and ground penetrating radar.
I'm a mechanical technician.
I'm a mechanical engineer here at the lab.
My background is in chemical engineering and bioengineering.
Technical lead in the industrial hygiene group.
Mechanical technician.
My background is actually in electrical engineering.
I'm the lead for machine learning driven vaccine and antibody design.
My normal job is a mechanical test engineer.
I am the section leader for the micro and nanotechnology section. We formed a team and immediately embarked upon creating a ventilator from a non-traditional supply chain to try to not disrupt the existing supply chain to the commercial ventilators. We have an enormous staff with broad and deep capabilities. The lab itself is a physical manufacturing capability that is spectacular.
There was a discussion among various members of the laboratory talking about the prospect of decontaminating N95 respirators for reuse. There's a national shortage of N95 respirators. I know our first-line healthcare providers are struggling with this and having to reuse them because of the shortage.
Small companies out there, as well as large companies, have started 3D printing these nasal swabs for testing. The problem is that we cannot evaluate them. So we stepped in to try and help evaluate the mechanical performance, the functional performance, to see, are these sufficient for the testing needs that we have?
We hope to build a pipeline, integrated pipeline of experimentation and computation that can support and help create countermeasure for this current pandemic, as well as help strengthen the preparedness for future pandemics.
About what we did was we were able to come up with a solution in such a short period of time to address the ventilator shortage issue by using materials that are not commonly used in the ventilator supply chain.
This project is specifically meant to assess whether you can use decontamination methods effectively to be able to reuse these N95 respirators, which are meant for single use. We were looking for ways to easily get that done through the use of readily available equipment, like a standard laboratory oven.
With our help, some commercial manufacturers have actually been able to demonstrate to clinicians that the products that they're producing are safe and they're effective for what they need to do. And so they've already started selling these commercially.
I believe that this is a very well directed effort and was able to bring a lot of different disciplines and different laboratories across the nation together and work towards one goal.
The team has been a remarkable group to work with. Many of us were drawn in for expertise and don't necessarily know each other.
It's been amazing to see the number of people who've been willing to step in and volunteer their time and their effort.
It was extremely motivating for me to be able to be involved in a project that would meet a national need.
Lawrence Livermore has had a long history of bringing together engineers, scientists, computer scientists, technicians to work together on teams that address several of our national security programs. People felt a strong commitment and a dedication to bring their capabilities to bear on an appropriate response to this crisis.